Hello, my friends. Welcome. My name is Brisa, and I'm so grateful that you are here with me today. Please watch this quick video so you know what to expect from class. The 75-minute yoga classes are actually recordings from the class that I offer every Sunday at noon from my home in North Carolina. I call this class Yoga for Cause Virtual Togetherness. It's a donation base where 100% of the funds go to the direct relief organization to support the coronavirus response. In these classes, I offer a variety of more advanced poses, but I also offer modifications and variations so all levels are welcome and feel supported throughout the practice. So please take good care of yourself and do what feels good in your body. Stop when you need, drink water when you have to, practice self-care. If you're pregnant, this won't be the class for you, but I also teach prenatal yoga and I would be happy to post some prenatal yoga classes at this channel. Just so send me a message if you are interested. If you're working with that injury or rehabilitating your body, please talk to your doctor to make sure that this is the right class for you. Also, I would like to introduce you to the yoga props, which I like to call enhancers. This is the yoga block. You can always use a stack of books. Yoga strap. You can use a rope belt. I like to always have a blanket for many purposes. Most of the classes you'll be using the blanket roll up. You can use a headband around to make sure it's nice and roll up tight. This is the barbell, 7 or 9 inches exercise ball, which I love to work with for so many reasons, but don't worry if you don't have one today. You can roll up to bath towels or go back to the blanket. Weights, optional, but definitely a great enhancer. Once you're ready, I'll meet you on your mat. Have an awesome practice. Namaste.
Find yourself on your mat, and I like to set up Fugama block to put the block behind the pillows, and the pillows will go under the armpit. So you want to lie down with the pillows, helping to open the chest as much as possible. You can have your arms extended on the sides. And if it feels good in your hips, you can take the soles of your feet together in Barakanasana. If that doesn't feel very good, you can have more pillows underneath your legs for support, or you can just extend your legs in front of you. Once you find your comfortable position, close your eyes or maybe keeping a soft gaze. Release your hips, tuck your tailbone away from your low back, and then bring your hips down on your mat again. Make sure that there's no pull on your low back at all, no compression, that it's anywhere uncomfortable. If the pillows don't serve you anything at all, just move them to the side and bring yourself to like the lie down shavasana. Find your breath. Just taking this time to notice your physical body, your energetic body. Maybe you just roll out of bed this morning, or maybe you've been up since 5 a.m. gardening and doing all kinds of stuff. Just notice the energy that is running through your body right now. If it's a sleepy energy, if it's a more awakening energy, maybe you just had a coffee so you feel a little bit of a caffeine buzz. And none of this is bad or good. It's just the feelings and the sensations in this moment
that you start to acknowledge. Using your attention to your breath, start changing the way you are breathing. And if you have a hard time connecting, you can take your hands on your ribs, or maybe on your heart and belly, or maybe you just want to have your arms soft. And start drawing in a deep ujjayi breath. If you're new to ujjayi breath, squeeze the back of your throat like you do when you try to fog a mirror and make an audible sound. Inhale, drawing in the energy from this day, this beautiful sunshine if you're North Carolina. Then where you are, it's maybe a different kind of weather, but drawing in that spring, that renewed energy into your cell tissue. And then exhale, find any places in your body, or maybe choose one place that you want to give this exhale to release tension. Inhale, lightness. Exhale, ease. The contact on the earth underneath your body is supporting you. Do two more very deep, mindful breaths this way. After this last exhale, when you're ready for your last breath, take a deeper breath yet, filling up all the way to your collarbones, and pause just for a moment. Let your body soak up your breath. And on your exhale, release and ease the exhale all the way out. Until your eyes open, you can just roll to your side just to get rid of the pillows. Push them to the side. Grab your strap or your robe, belt, whatever it is that you have today. Bring it right next to you and take your left leg up. Bring your left knee into your left shoulder. Avoid your rib cage. Just bring in elbows close to your body. Might feel nice to stay still, or maybe feels good to kind of move your knees circles to feel where your hip is in place and what is the feeling in the hip. Is it tight? Is it sore? Is it feeling great? Maybe circle your ankles. And then a couple of options. If your hamstring needs a little bit more self-care,
You can keep your left knee bent and just open the left leg out to the side with the knee bent. If you want a little bit more hamstring, that's kind of where we're heading today, lots of hamstring. You can take the left leg up and have this strap around the ball of your left foot. Flex your ankle, turn the toes towards your shin, and slowly let your left leg open to the left. Left hand grabs both sides of your strap, right hand on your right hip bone. Just so you notice, if your right buttocks is lifting off the floor, you went too much, too deep today. So just keep the right glute down as you open the left hip. You don't have to go to your 100% edge right now. Just allow your body to soften and open naturally. Using your breath to guide that spacious feeling. On your next inhale, bring your left leg up. This time, right hand grabs both sides of your strap. On your exhale, start letting that leg to fall all the way to the right. And I'm letting a little bit of space here, but you can go all the way as a twist if you like. That means maybe your left foot is over a block or maybe touching the floor. You can also just do kind of like an IT bend stretch if that's where you prefer to be today, which is your left foot goes about mid body or a little bit, but not all the way in the spinal twist. I personally love this spinal twist in the beginning of the class, but sometimes if your back is a little sensitive today, you might just need to warm it up for it before you get there. And this can all be done with the knee bent. If you chose to work that way, and your knee will be bent as you twist to the right. One more deep breath. Create space between the ribs and the hip. Big sigh. Inhale, left leg up. Bring both hands, get rid of your strap so it's not on your way. Options, either half happy baby or grab your foot with your both hands for a lying down pigeon. And you can even do like a rocking hip situation right here where you just move your foot up and down, up towards the belly button. And excuse me, down towards the belly button, up towards chest bones and chin. If you have happy baby, right hand can be on your right hip. Keep the right glute down. On your exhale, release the left leg down. Let's do the same sequence, hip sequence on the right side, right knee towards right shoulder. Exhale, bring it in first, just to notice how your hips feeling. Maybe a totally different sensation on the right side. Circle ankle on the right foot. Spread the toe. Notice if your jaw is holding tension. Might feel nice to create circles with your right knee. This first moment in class, after the breath and before we get to our core, is all about just noticing your body, tuning in to those sensations, those qualities, and make you feel good. You don't have to be stagnant some way if you feel more flowy, but also you can be more in a still motion if you need that to help steer your mind. Strap on the right foot if you choose to extend the leg. Exhale, flex the ankle, reach the heel up. Keep your shoulders down so you can get a very loose grip on your strap so your arms are soft, shoulder blades down.
can feel for closing your eyes if you like. Maybe just keep your eyes just soft, please. Right hand grabs the strap, left hand on your left hip, open up to the right. You can choose to have your right knee bent. No need to go super deep right now. On the next inhale, leg comes up. Prepare for that twist. You can either bend your right knee and twist with the knee bent, or have the leg extend, or do the hip stretch by taking the leg just of maybe 6 inches to the left side of your body and not going fully to the twist. On your inhale, spread your ribs. Exhale, roll your right hip down away from your waist. Relax your shoulders. On your next inhale, bring your right leg up, and you can release the strap, either happy baby, half happy baby, right leg, or pigeon, reclined pigeon, grabbing the foot, and maybe just sway your foot towards chin, towards belly button. Just realize that maybe my music is just a little too loud for you guys, so let me turn it down. One more breath here. And then bring the left leg up and go into both legs happy baby, just for a breath. Encourage your tailbone down towards the mat. And from here, elbow to knee. Keep your feet off the floor, bring your feet, active feet, knees over sacrum, clasp your 10 fingers, bring behind your head. Elbows up, exhale, press the low back down. Inhale, bring your head and shoulders up. Hold your breath, curl the big one up towards your navel. Exhale, elbows left, extend the right leg in front of you, 45 degree, pull low belly down. Inhale, back to center. Hold your breath, curl the big one up. Exhale, elbows right, extend the left leg. Reach through the ball of the left foot, pull low belly down. Inhale, back to center, knees over your sacrum. Keep shoulders off the floor, hold. Curl pubic bone up towards your navel. Exhale, elbows left, extend the right. Make sure your left shoulder blade, left shoulder is off the floor. Pull low belly down. Inhale, back to center. Notice if you start arching your low back, keep that focus. Hold your breath, curl pubic bone up. Exhale, elbows right, extend the left leg. Curl pubic bone a second time, pull low belly down. Inhale, back to center. Hold your breath, curl pubic bone up. Exhale, elbows left, extend the right leg forward. Right glute contract, curl pubic bone up, pull low belly down. Inhale, back to center, all those little subtle movements. Hold your breath, curl to big bone. Exhale, elbows right knee, extend the left. Squeeze the left glute. Curl to big bone up towards your navel. Second time, pull low belly down. Last two, inhale. Pause, curl to big bone up. Exhale, elbows left knee, extend right leg. Pull low belly down. Last one, inhale. Big deep belly breath, pause. Curl pubic bone up, press low back down. Exhale, elbows right, extend the left. Squeeze the left glute. Pull low belly down.
Inhale, shoulders inhale down. Feet down on the mat. Just lay your knees fall to the left and fall to the right. One more time, sigh. Take your hands behind your knees, coming to half boat. You can keep your hands behind your knees. Keep your spine as a neutral spine, part of the head, reach away from the tailbone, but a little bit inclined. And then we're gonna lower and lift. Lower and lift. Lower and lift. Last three. Last two. Last one. Hold. Low boat. Take one more deep breath. Exhale. Curl yourself up. Cross your legs in front of you. And come to all fours. Knees on the hips. And hands on the shoulders. That's my notes away from me. Let's do a sphinx. So you're just gonna come down. Your elbows on the shoulders. Just let your abs get a nice stretchy feeling right here. Hips soft, legs soft. Use your grip from your elbows and draw your chest forward. Bring your hands on your shoulders, push yourself up. Grab your weights if you have, you don't need it. But just have it on you and bring it behind your right leg for all fours, glute work. Flex your foot, lift the leg up so it's a right angle with the leg. Pull your belly in. Lower and lift. Just focus on the song, lower. It's a two count, lift. Now we can break down a little bit. If you need to go to your forearms, you can do this on your forearms. If you have any wrist, shoulder, discomfort at any point. Elbows are soft, so you're not locking your elbows. What's definitely not soft is your belly. Hold your low belly in. And if you want to add a little bit more core, left arm can go in front of you and can reach and bring it in. When you lift your heel, imagine you pressing your heel up towards the sky. That's when you engage your belly the most to create resistance so your glute can work a little harder and you protect your low back. Last four. Last three. Last two. This time you're gonna hold it up and just pulse. Lift, lift. This is when you really focus on your belly, guys. Pull your belly in and move your right heel up just about an inch. So you're just allowing that knee to come down an inch. Push back up again. Lift. Last four, three, two, hold. Pull belly in. Shoulders away from your ears. Keep the heel up high. Squeeze the heel towards the glute. Exhale, release. Bring the weight to the other side. Flex your on the ankle, squeeze heel towards glute, lift the leg up. Lower and lift. Really move this in slow motion first so you can notice your low back. Your low back should be still like a picture. It's not flexing at all, not collapsing. your belly is hugging in like crazy towards your spine, especially towards the highest point of your heel. Very similar to elbow to knee, you curl pubic bone towards your navel as you reach to the highest point. Exhale to lift. Option to extend the right arm forward and low. That tricks your balance a little bit, so your core has to work a little deeper and more connected to stabilize your body. Come to forearms anytime you need. Last four. Last three. Last two. This time we're gonna hold it up and pulse. Keep your shoulders melting away from your ears. Even the right arm that is extended forward. Keep going. Lift, lift. Last eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, just hold. Hold belly in. Keep the heel forward, upwards, and squeeze it in one more time. One more inhale. Exhale to release your hand down. Take the weight to your side. Come to child's pose. Open your knees wider than your hips if you like, so your ribcage can just slip through your legs. Chest, heart melt down towards the earth. Hands are actively extending and wrapping shoulder blades towards your armpit so you can open your upper back and use your chest. One more breath. Big sigh. Push yourself up. Come to all fours again. Curl your back toes under. Now, this is an interesting part. If you have a block, you can bring between your legs to give a little squeeze there. If you have a barbell, one of those exercise balls that I love, you can use that. It's a lot better. But the block will do today. Lift your knees up just a half inch off the floor. Tap and lift. Tap, lift. Tap, lift, tap. Just follow the song if that helps you stay focused. When you lift, don't feel like it's your foot pushing down on the ground. Feel like it's your belly pulling up, like you do crow pose or when you do a handstand. You curl into the belly, similar to also when you do plank and downward facing dog. Last four, three, two, just hold. One more deep inhale. Exhale, knees down. Take the block or the ball next to you. Prepare for plank, feet back. Forearm plank, totally amazing. If you have wrist, shoulder discomfort, it's actually, I think it's harder to do on your forearms. So just find one that works for you. You can also have your knees down at any point. We're gonna move just in a little flow here. Bend the knees, straight, bend, straight. When you bend your knees, feel for your belly to stabilize everything because you're not using your glutes and your legs anymore. Bend, straight, bend, straight. Soft to bend the elbows. Roll your shoulders down.
4, 3, 2, 1. Take a deep inhale. Exhale, downward facing dog. Use your belly. Just turn on to lift your hips up. Bend the knees for this first one, first moment. And lift your tailbone up away from your heels to get a nice long spine and open for your shoulders. And stretch for your upper back. Find your ujjayi breath. Notice the sensations on your body right now. Shoulders away from your ears. Start easing your heels down. They might touch, they might not. Doesn't matter. As long as your spine is straight. And just start moving, creating a little bit more movement on your down dog, just so you can open your side body. Your hip. And start walking forward towards a forward fold. Feet about hip distance. Let your neck be soft. Deep bend on the knees, this first one. Exhale everything out. Strong press to your feet. Pull your belly in, inhale, slowly rise. Reach your arms all the way up towards the sky. Grab your right wrist to get inhale, reach up towards the sky, exhale, bend to your left, bump your hips to your right. Inhale back to center, grab your left wrist. Inhale, reach palms up, tailbone down, exhale, bump your hips to the left, reach your palms to the right. Inhale back to center. Exhale, palms and heart. Let's begin our B series. Just want to make sure that this microphone is not doing anything weird. Inhale, come into your chair. Shift your booty all the way back, way to your heels. Ease your shoulders away from your ears. One more inhale. Exhale, dive deep to your fold. Inhale, scoop your chest away from your thighs. Crown of the head, reach forward, shoulders away from ears. Exhale, fold, bend the knees if you like, or if you need. Inhale, plant your hands, step back into plank. Set your knees down first. Bend elbows close to your ribs. Lower down without collapsing your shoulders towards the floor. Cobra, hands on the shoulders. Inhale, pull your chest forward. Press your pubic bone and your thighs down. Exhale to release. Hands on the shoulders. Curl back toes. Lift into your down facing dog. One more breath here. Option to flow with me in that push-up series. Inhale, left leg up and back. Exhale, tap the left tricep. Inhale to that push-up, one leg plank. And then push back knee to the right elbow. Inhale, left leg up and back. Exhale, step through runner's lunge. Flow your fingers off the mat about an inch. Step the left knee over your left ankle. Come to the ball of your right foot heel, push forward. Hands behind your sacrum, clasp your fingers, squeeze your shoulder blades together, squeeze the palms together. Keep long to neck, left kneecap are tracking over the second toe. One more breath here. Exhale to release. We're gonna move into our flow of the day today. Hands down. Bring right knee to the left outer thigh, left outer calf. Then push it back and open the twist, right hand on the floor, left arm opens up. And we're gonna move in a two count. Let's do it, knee in, push it back. Open and close.
Lean in, squeeze, push it back. Follow the beat of the song if that makes you feel more comfortable and more flowy. Last one like this, and you can stay here or option to do standing splits. Split and lower, open and close. Split, lower, open, close. You got it. Lift. Find your breath. Let's chew all the way through. Last one. Plant your hands down. Inhale, left leg up and back. Just get a nice stretch here for the left glute. Exhale, step through between your hands, and then you have to watch me this one. Your left hand goes out, press through your right hand, right leg floats through. Don't sit yet, just slowly float down. Take your left foot over the left thigh for a twist. Inhale to lift your chest, wrap your right arm around the left thigh. Exhale, look over left shoulder. Don't worry, if you got confused, we're gonna do a few of this, and by the end of the class, you'll get it. Inhale, back to center. Figure four, right foot plants down the mat, left ankle over right thigh. Press your hands down, and just kind of flow your glute back and forth. This is an option. If you prefer just to be sitting on the figure four, that's totally fine. If your wrists need a little love, you can just be in a figure four. And bring your hips down, circle your left ankle, one direction and then the other. And we're gonna prepare to float the right leg back opposite way we went in, right leg down. Left foot on the inner side of your right leg. Press the right hand down, left arm extends to the side, push your buttocks, and then take your right leg back. Need that crescent lunge. Plant your both hands down with your left leg up. Exhale, lower. Let's do the other side. Inhale, right leg up and back. Flow with me if you like on the push-up series. Tap the outer right arm. Push into one leg plank for a push-up option. Tap the left elbow. Inhale, right leg up and back, one leg downward dog. Exhale, step through, runner's lunge, fingers flow off the floor. Right kneecap, tracking of a second toe to protect your knee. Press your right foot down, touching on your glute. Clasp your hands behind you. Take an inhale, squeeze your shoulder blades back. Exhale, ease your shoulders away from your ears. And then turn and face the other way. One more breath here. Belly's in, back heel forward. Exhale to release your hands. Find it to count. Bring the knee. Push it back. Open and close. I like to do four of this and then go to the split. Just to get a nice feeling, but you can stay on this the whole time, splits just not for you, maybe it's too early in the practice to go to a split. You can move in a four count from the move very slowly in your own pace. Please do that. Moving to the split, lift, lower, open, and close. Feel free to have stack of books, blocks, something under your hands to make this more accessible or to enhance your practice in any way. Find your breath. When you're floating in space like this, keep bringing your attention to your breath, or to any feelings or attitude or thoughts that arise, so you can continue to sharpen your internal gaze and just notice what's happening with you. Notice if you need any adjustment. Last two. Last one. Plant your hands down. Inhale, right leg up. One leg down, dog. Exhale, step through. Keep your left hand on the floor, right hand goes out to the side. Flow your left leg in front of you. Softly in. Right foot over the left thigh. Right hand can go behind your hip, left arm wraps around right thigh. Inhale, lift your chest. Exhale, look over right shoulder. Inhale, back to center. Bend the bottom knee. Figure four. Shift your hips back and forth if you like, or just stay sitting down. Flex the right ankle, get a little bit deeper into that right hip. This feels so good after that glute work that we just did. Sit down, roll your right ankle, move one way, then the other. Extend the left leg in front of you. Right foot on the inner side of your left leg. Plant your left hand next to your left hip. Right arm extend out of the right shoulder. Press with your right foot in your left hand. Flow your left leg back into that crescent lunge. Plant your hands. Inhale, right leg up and back, one leg down or dog. Exhale to lower. Inhale, bend your knees, look between your hands. Exhale, jump or step forward, forward fold. Inhale, squat. Pivot on your feet so it's wider than hip. Turn your toes slightly out. Maybe just 11 and 1. Bring your chest up. Put your belly in. Hips back. Knees press out like you're pushing to your band if you had tight around your thighs. Take one more inhale. Relax your shoulders. Exhale, plant your hands in front of you. Bakasana crow. Lift your tiptoes. Knee, as if you can get right on the inside of your armpit, start shifting your weight to your hands and lift your feet off the floor. When you're ready, press back into plank, lower down, chaturanga. Inhale, either cobra or up dog. Bend elbows slightly if you're up dog, squeeze your shoulder blades back. Press your feet down. Squeeze your glutes. Exhale, use your belly. Lift your hips up. Downward facing dog. Inhale, left leg up. Flow with me if you like for the push-up. Tap left arm. One leg push-up. Tap right elbow. Inhale, left leg up and back. Exhale, step through warrior two. Pivot on your back foot. Right arm pulls you up like a rainbow. Palms up. Press your outer right foot down on the floor. Turn on your right thigh, right glute. Gently press the outer left knee out. Kneecap tracking over second toe. Tailbone reaches down towards the mat. Away from your low back. Ribcage lifting up away from your waist. Keep shoulders down. Let's flow into a reverse and extend just for a few. Inhale, reach the left arm up, exhale, reach back. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, reach forward. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, reach to the other side. This time, inhale, come back into extended warrior. You can take the left elbow on the thigh if you like, or you can do a little bit more of a core work. Both arms reach up, like in a warrior one, shoulders down. Roll your left shoulder forward, spinning your chest forward. Four, three, pull your belly in, one. Draw your thumbs towards your chest, modified triangle. Extend the left leg, just don't push the back knee down. Just keep just a slight micro bend on the knee to protect the backside. Reach the crown of the head forward, shoulders down, and maybe you can relax your neck. Strong connection through the right leg, right glute tight, left thigh contracted. Take one more deep breath and stay somewhere. Exhale, open your arms. I can move a little bit deep into that stretch and the twist. Tailbone reaching towards right heel, the back foot. One more breath. Exhale, bend your knee, front knee, come into a warrior two, and reverse. Reach back, cover your hands. One leg downward dog, left leg reaches up high. Now follow me. On your exhale, you're gonna step through on the outer left hand. Pivot on both feet like you're going to a side plank for a side plank twist. If you know the correct name of this pose, please let me know after class. I'd love to know. Press your hips up. Shoulders away from your ears. One more breath. When you exhale, just land your right hip down. Prepare for our, this is another name I came up with, our dragonfly prelude. Left hand tracks over the left chin. Grab the foot, it can be through the thumb or the outer edge. Fingers, right hand forward. Squeeze the elbow into your chest and ribcage. Press the right hand and left foot down. Try to get the glute and the whole right thigh off the floor. Exhale, release down. Walk your hands to the top of your mat, let's to the other side. Inhale, left leg up and back. Exhale, float the leg down. Inhale, rolling up. Exhale, option to flow with me for our ab work. Tap the outer arm. One leg push up. Tap the left elbow. Inhale, right leg up. Exhale, warrior two. Pivot on the back foot, left arm pulls you up. Palms up. Bend your right knee, step over right ankle. Gently press the outer right knee to the side, kneecap tracking second toe. Strong left leg. Strong left glute. Pull your belly in, leg the table down. Let's flow into reverse and extend. Inhale, right arm up. Exhale, reach back. Inhale, back to center. Exhale, reach forward. Inhale. Exhale. This time, inhale, back to center. Option to take right elbow to right thigh for extended warrior variation, or both arms up, Keep melting your shoulders down. Turning on your lats, wrapping shoulder blades towards your armpit. Belly's in. Notice if you tying it up to your jaw, to your neck. Strong left thigh, press the outer left foot down. Four, three, two, exhale, draw your thumbs to your chest. Extend the front leg for triangle. Just allow your torso to start moving towards that second toe on your right foot. Tailbone towards your left heel. One more breath here, find space. Shoulders away from ears. Exhale, option to open your both arms. Maybe your right hand lands on a block. Make sure you're not pushing your right knee down towards the mat. I like to just soften my neck in this pose. This is one of my favorite poses, with the neck soft. So you can try that if you like. One more breath. Exhale to bend your right knee. Inhale to rise into warrior two. And then reverse. Let's flow together. Inhale, cartwheel your hands flat on the either side of your right foot. Inhale, right leg up and back. Then one leg down, dog on the sweet sides here. And we're gonna move to that same step through for that foot on the outer right hand. Leave it on both feet, just like when we do a side plank, and then press your hips up and open your chest. Nice hip opener, core strengthening. On the next exhale, release your hips down. Prepare for dragonfly prelude. Reach the right arm in front of you. Grab somehow your left foot. Press your left hand, elbow hugging to the rib, and right foot down. Lift your left leg and your hip off the mat. Soft to land. Hands on the top of your mat. Inhale, right leg up and back. One leg downward dog. Exhale to lower. Inhale, bend your knees, look in between your hands. Exhale, jump or step forward, forward fold. Inhale, scoop your chest away from your thighs. Exhale, fold. Inhale, chair. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, lengthen space. Exhale, fold. Inhale, plant your hands, step back, plank. Shift on the tiptoes, bend your elbows, shoulders away from your ears and away from your floor. Top of the feet down, press up into upward facing dog. Soft bend elbows, squeeze shoulder blades back, press your feet down. Exhale, downward facing dog. You go in last sequence. Inhale, left leg up and back. Exhale, step through crescent lunge. Rise. Inhale, reaching the arms up. Exhale, side bend. Left arm goes to the right thigh. Behind the thigh, hamstring. Right hand stands and lean towards the left side of your body. One more breath here. Find space to the right side. Keep your right shoulder away from your right ear. Left arm spins forward. Inhale to come up. Palms to touch. Back bend. Relax your head back. Inhale, ribcage up. Exhale, reach your hands back. Look back. Go back. In this pose, your right foot is doing a lot of the work. You push so strong to the right foot, your right leg is completely strong, and it's really where you find all your balance is the back leg. You can always take the modification with clasped hands behind your head if you have any neck issues. On your inhale, slowly rise. On your exhale, bring your palms together, heart. Take a deep inhale to length. Exhale, you're gonna twist your left side. Right hand on the outside of your left foot. You can be on a block, you can be on the floor. Left arm goes up. You don't have to go as deep if you don't like. You can also have your right hand on the inner side of your left foot with the hand on the block. You can also have your back arm on a half bind if that feels more comfortable for your shoulder. Inhale to lay through the top of your head, all the way forward where your toes are pointing. Exhale to twist shoulders away from your ears. Prepare for revolving half moon. Right hand in front of your left foot into the right, just a few inches. Big step forward, right leg rises, flex the right ankle, toes pointing straight out. Press the inner left foot to lift your right hip, right glute up towards the sky so you're not collapsing. Twist from the upper back. Option here, you can stay here or do a bind with me. Bend the left knee, meet me crescent lunge again with a bind. This might be a little bit tricky because I have like all my wires for my microphone. Hopefully they will stay in place. And then start rising into a bind revolving half moon. Lower the leg down. Plant your hands down. Inhale, left leg up and back. One leg down, facing up. Exhale, step through. In that crescent lunge, runner's lunge, excuse me. Press the right hand down, left arm out to the shoulder. Flow the right leg in front of you. Soft land. Take your left leg over for half knee pile. Left heel on the side of your right hip. Inhale to length, find your forward fold. Exhale, use your chest towards the left knee. One more breath here. Inhale, pull yourself up. Bend your right knee, right foot on the floor. Find the figure four again. Wrap your right arm around your left foot. Left arm around. And do a little bit of a rocking the baby. So open that hip. Right leg now is extended forward. You guys ready for something fun? Okay, I'm gonna go face this way. From here, elephant trunk. Grab your left foot. I'm gonna be a little bit sideways so you can see better. Take your left leg over on the left shoulder, over the shoulder. Hug that very tight towards your shoulder. Lift the buttocks up, that's first stage. Then just lifting the heel up. And if you can, Astavastaka, take the right foot on top of the left foot. Start squeezing the legs together as you bend your both arms. Look to your right foot. And then push yourself back. Same way we went in, right leg in front of you. Press your left hand down. Your right hand now, excuse me, left arm opens out of the left shoulder. Step back. Inhale, left leg up and back. Exhale, soft landings to the other side. Inhale, right leg up. Exhale, step through crescent lunge. Rise. Inhale, lift your chest up. Exhale, right hand behind the left thigh, side bend. Find space to your neck, left shoulder away from ear. Inhale, right hand, spin forward, beat the left hand, back bend. Exhale, drop your head back. Inhale, lift your chest and your fingers up. Exhale, look back. Strong connection to your left leg. Really push down to the ball of the left foot. Inhale to come up. Palms at heart. Exhale, move into that twist. Opening your hands for bringing the left hand on the inside of your right foot. Shoulders away from your ears. Strong right heel pushing down. Revolving half moon. Left hand in front and to the left side. Press into your right foot. Flex your back foot. Toes pointing down. Press your right foot in the floor where your big toe is. Lift your left hip up. Make it very flat on top of your sacrum. Option to stay here or bring the leg down. Find your half bind or your full bind. And start moving to revolving half moon with the bind. Soften in. Knees down. Inhale, right leg up. One leg downward up. Exhale, step through. Right arm opens to the right. Left leg floats forward. Sit down. Right knee on top. For half knee pile, forward fold. Inhale, lengthen, scoop the chest away from your belly button. Exhale, ease your way down. One of my main goals today is finish fast on time. I want to let you know that we are in a good track. So just be calm. You don't have to leave earlier. You can just stay all the way to the end. Inhale, slowly rise. Find your figure four. Left foot down. Maybe just sway here or sway back and forth. Flex the right ankle. And then take your left arm, wrap around the right foot. Extend the left leg in front of you, rock the knee. Ready for something fun? On the other side. Take elephant trunk first. And you can stay in elephant trunk. You can be right here. It's kind of like a half happy baby. And you can be right here if that's where you want to be. If you want to go into the elephant trunk, hug the knee into your right shoulder, hands pushed down, fingers forward, press the buttocks up, press the left leg up, and then if you can, step the left foot over your right foot, and start banging your elbows as you squeeze your legs together between your thighs. So your thighs squeeze to your right arm. Then make your way back, if you can. Your left leg is in front. Right foot on the inner left thigh. Press the right hand, left hand down, right arm opens to the side. Push, pull the leg back. Hands down, inhale, right leg up. Exhale, leg down. Child's pose. Open your knees wide, bring your forehead to the floor. Two deep breaths. Slowly make your way up. Left knee pigeon. Take your left knee towards your left wrist. Extend the right leg back. Inhale, lift your chest. Exhale, ease your way down. Feel free to bring pillows under your left hip. Maybe pillows underneath your forehead. Two more breaths. Hands on the shoulders, left knee back, right knee towards right wrist, pigeon on the right side. Wiggle your hips, inhale, lift your chest. You can stay up here if that's where you feel like you get the most out of this pose, maybe one or two breaths, and then when you're ready, you can come down. If pigeon is not for you, you can go down to your back and do a half happy baby or a happy baby. Anything that will release your back and get into your hips one more time. Two more breaths on this side. You can ease your way out and find the most comfortable way to practice Shavasana. Resting pose or sitting or legs up the wall, blankets, pillows under your knees, whatever it is that gives you that most settling comfort place so you can just be in your stillness. The options here are, if you like to have a Shavasana with music, Faith Hymn, I think maybe that's how you say it, it's the very last song. It's a beautiful music. If you like to just focus on that, that helps you relax. If you don't like music, you can just stop the music altogether. I'm just going to guide you through a breath work. I did have a beautiful meditation to share with you, but I realized I'm recording with the phone and the meditation is on the phone. So I'll have to print that for next week so it makes it a little easier for me to access. So I'll owe you for that. You know, today was just a relaxation in breath. Find your Shavasana. You can mute me if you prefer to be just with the music or quiet, just for 3 minutes, 4 minutes. Close your eyes. Take a very deep breath in. Take a pause at the top. Big sigh. Just find your body and your mind settling in this time. And then now. Notice if there's any tension around your eyebrows, your skin that cover your eyes, your cheeks, your jaw, and
So releasing your face. And as you soften through your face, notice what that does to your mind and the rest of your body. Allow your breath to be as normal as possible. And you can choose to focus on where you're breathing and the quality of your breath. Maybe just the sounds surrounding you, like the music, maybe some birds singing outside, distant traffic. And as you notice all those things, just allow them to be in the same space in you without trying to change them or avoid them or embrace them. They're just there. Same with your thoughts. Just passing through like clouds in the sky. Like the wind blowing on the leaves. Notice how often your mind flows outside of this moment, outside of your body, and without any judgments or expectations, just gently and lovingly bring your mind back to your breath or to the sounds that you chose to pay attention to. That awareness keep coming back is the meditation itself. It's not supposed to be perfect. It's not supposed to be as still as possible. It's just acknowledging what the mind does, which it wants to be in different places at the same time, and be able to guide the mind to your home base, to your breath, or to the sounds, to your body sensations. One more breath here. And as you're ready, slowly start bringing movement into your body. Maybe taking that deep stretch or just rolling to one side so you can find a comfortable sitting position when you're ready. But please feel free, if you need more time in Shavasana, you can take this time for yourself. Now sitting or even laying down, if you chose to lay down, maybe one hand to your heart, one hand to your belly. Sitting down, palms together. Take a deep inhale, drawing the beautiful energy of this day, of the spring, of the moon, into your whole body, cell tissue. Thank you so much, everyone. Such an honor to be here with you. Namaste. I want to thank you again for practicing with me. I hope this practice helped you get on your body, connected with your breath, inspired you to live in a more mindful way. May we be well. May we be free from pain and suffering. May we be happy. Namaste.